feel very thankful and have such wonderful friends and family here to celebrate Stuart and Wynn's wedding. Having you here makes this day even more wonderful. Stuart, you have a genominous. Ginormous heart in the soul of a peacemaker. And we love you much. Your mother often wished she could keep you safely tucked in bubble wrap, but that really wasn't the case because you have an independent spirit. Your charming smile and independent style, we wish you could see yourself through our eyes. Then you would have a glimpse of truly how loved and special you are to us. Your mother and I were the moon happy when you called to tell us you asked Wynn to marry you, and she said yes. It was a feeling of indescribable elation. This sounds like me talking, right? A lot like how we felt the day you were born. The big difference was we only had to wait 9 months for you to arrive, and the proposal took about 7 years plus. Stephen, Noel, and Bruce and Deb had the best RSVPs on your return to the wedding when they said, "Finally." We agree, but we have to admit it was worth the wait. We love Wynn. She embodies all that we ever hoped that you would find in the love of your life, and even more. She takes you to church. Remember the day when you arrived with the big black puppy for your 26th birthday? That was the first time we met Wynn, and we knew then that she was the one for you. The way you looked at each other was a big giveaway. Your mother loved Wynn immediately sprawled on the floor next to the puppy and gave him the special Wynn hug. When you get a Wynn hug, you know she means it. And I could go on.
I can't read.
It has been a treat to watch your love grow over the 7 years. It's easy to see. You two have couple strength, and it has definitely stood the standard and the test of time. When? Wow, what a precious new grandson and a fantastic new daughter in 2 weeks. It doesn't get much better than that. We love you, and we're thrilled that you and Stuart find each other. If there was ever one person in this entire world that we would pick for him, it would be you. Win for your kind heart, generous soul, and intuitive spirit. Thank you for doing what is right, good, and nurturing. Thank you for being you. To the trans, you raised an amazing, loving, and compassionate young woman. It is often said that when children find true love, parents find true joy. I couldn't agree more. It is a joy to share our children with such a warm and loving family. Stuart and Wynn, here's the joy and love from this day forward. And I think my sensitivity's taken over, so.
Board games, my personal favorite, which was pestering and annoying my sister, as a little sister always should do. So naturally, for the bridal shower I threw her a couple weeks ago, I incorporated several games. Unfortunately, I was only able to fit in one game. So I figured tonight's the night to make it right. Bubba? When it's due, can you please come to the front? Now, I don't know if you've heard of this game. It's called the shoe game. Don't be shy. You both love games, so it's going to be fine. Back to back, there we go. Now, it's called the shoe game because you're going to trade one of your shoes with each other. So you'll have one of your shoes and one of Stu's shoes. And Sue's going to have one of his shoes and one of Wynn's shoes. And I'm going to ask you questions, and obviously you can't see each other and how you're going to answer. And you're going to guess who is the appropriate person for that question. Are you ready? Here's an easy one. Who's got cash on them right now? Stu? Is it Stu? Are you going to trade shoes? So you're going to hold the shoes, and when I ask the question, you're going to raise the person's shoe that you think fits the bill. So now you're going to give Stu your shoe win. There you go. There you go. And then when you're going to take your other shoe off, so you have a shoe in your hand for yourself. Don't worry. We'll get some sanitizer before the meal. So it's fun. It's a game. You like games, Wynn. So you used to. All right, ready? Who made the first move? You gotta raise higher than that. Okay. Who said, "I love you" first? Who says, "I love you" more? Who says, "I'm sorry" first after a fight? So pulling from Father Tom's homily, who's the best answer? Who is the better driver? Now, who's got the messier car, though? Who's the better cook? You gotta raise it proud with. Who wears the pants in the relationship? Who is more likely to be running late? Who takes the longest to get ready? Okay, there may be a correlation there. Who is the better athlete? Who is a bigger baby when they are sick? Who manages the finances? Who's funnier? Who's more stubborn? That was a fast one. I think that was a record there. Who spends more time on social media? Who is likely to be the first one to fall asleep tonight? We're almost done. Who is usually in control of the remote? Who's better at game night? And who is the more diehard Hokie fan? tonight. Even though I enjoy playing games, especially annoying my sister, she was and forever will be more than a sister to me. She's my best friend and a role model. Yes, we know how to push each other's buttons, but that's because we've been through it all together. When Sue and Wynn started dating, and even to this day, Wynn would say to me, you know, you and Wynn, or you and Sue are just so similar, all the time. And at first it kind of bothered me, I wasn't sure why, but we have impeccable taste in food, this is true. We also have an affinity for golf, but especially recently, as I began to reflect, I realized that, unfortunately, she was right. We do have similarities. Sue is Wynn's best friend. She's right. Wynn, I'm so happy today that you married your best friend. You've been such a role model to me. You're strong, passionate, ambitious, smart, generous, kind, and demonstrate integrity. I'm so proud of the woman that you've become today, and you inspire me deeply. Wynn and Stu, together, you're selfless. You're always putting other people's needs before your own. You both have a knack for always making friends and bringing people together. So tonight, we are here to not only celebrate the love that you have for each other, but the deep friendship that you have. So tonight, we're not just your friends, but we're all united as family to celebrate you and the friendship that we have with you and the friendship that you have with each other. Cheers.
Yeah, you can keep your shoes on. I'd like to start out by thanking Mr. and Mrs. Shaganon, Mr. and Mrs. Tran, Stu and Wynn for this incredible day. The ceremony was absolutely beautiful. This venue is stunning. We know you put a lot of time and effort into everything that you did to pull this all together. On behalf of everybody here in this room, thank you very much for inviting all of us. We're so happy to be here and to celebrate Stu and Wynn. So my name's Chad. I've known Stu for now over 20 years. When I first met Stu, he had the same baby face that he still has now today. I've aged 20 years, Stu hasn't aged a single day. It's a little frustrating. We go all the way back to middle school. You know, and we've been together side by side through every phase of life. It's incredible to have a close friend like that through every major event through life. It started back in middle school when we first met, having sleepovers, playing night games in our backyard, running through Manordale Farms and other people's neighborhoods. Some of you are here. Tag league golf and school dances. Funny thing about the school dances, and some of you may remember, we didn't do a lot of dancing. We stayed in the gymnasium and played a lot of sports, probably why Stu's a little rhythmically challenged than he is now. Sorry, Wynn. From middle school, we went on to high school. Where we played lacrosse together. Stu actually was the one who got me involved in lacrosse and started playing lacrosse. Snowboarding trips, A lot of trips to Seven Springs, maybe driving down the highway a little faster than what we should have been getting out to Seven Springs, but we always made it there. Family vacations to Ocean City, a rolled Ford Explorer, and a lot of other fun events. That wasn't fun. We graduated high school and went to Virginia Tech together as well. Love Virginia Tech so much that we both wanted to spend 5 years there instead of four. At Virginia Tech, it was football games and tailgates, living together off campus, a lot of road trips, Mrs. Shagan, of course, all of the studying that we did at Virginia Tech, and our dinners every night in the dining hall with all of our close friends. The funny thing about Stu with the dining hall is I don't think I ever saw Stu cook a single meal in about the first 15 years that I knew him. We were always eating at the dining halls. After college, he ordered so much takeout where he memorized his credit card, he could probably recite in his sleep if he ever stopped snoring. After Virginia Tech, we both moved to DC together. He wouldn't stop following me around. DC, it was flag football, concussions, injuries, backyard barbecues, endless hours in his basement watching Steeler games, and a lot of golf. In my opinion, not enough golf. In my wife's opinion, and probably Wynn's opinion, way too much golf. Really throughout all of those events, Stu, you know, we've been together for 20 years, side by side. You've been my best friend, but you've also been like a brother to me. I couldn't ask for a better friend, and I'm so happy to be able to share this moment with you guys. So about 7 years ago, around this time, you know, as friends do, talking about girls, and Stu is going on and on about this girl, Wynn. How cool she was, how fun she was, how beautiful she was. So finally, I got this opportunity to go meet Wynn. Wynn was throwing a party at her house. An anti-Valentine's Day party of all things. Look at Sue, I'm like, dude, you sure you want to try to date this girl? She's throwing an anti-Valentine's Day party, I don't know. So I go to this party and I immediately see what Sue sees in Wynn. She's so energetic, so bubbly, so kind to everybody that she meets. It was a couple months later that I knew that Wynn was right for Stu. We're sitting there talking what we were gonna do for that weekend, what were the plans and all that. And Stu says to me, Wynn's gonna come over and I'm gonna cook. And I was in utter disbelief. Stu, cook? Pretty sure you don't know where the kitchen is in your own house. Happy to say, you know, that night went well and they've been happily cooking meals together ever since. Wynn, I am so happy that Stu found you. You are such an incredible person. You have tremendous love for your family, great faith in God, you're passionate and driven in your career, and you are genuinely the sweetest person that I have ever met. I am so happy for the two of you today and every day. So on this day, to celebrate your wedding, I'd like you guys to do one thing. Again, you can keep your shoes on. Stu, you can grab Wynn by the hand, put your hand on top of hers, and cherish this moment, because it's the last time in your marriage you'll ever have the upper hand. Stu, Wynn, to a lifetime of love, health, and happiness. Cheers.